alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Jacksonville State Gamecocks and the East Tennessee State Bucks. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
You need your starting five to be the unit who will be intense and also understand what the coach wants early in the game.
We're set for the tip-off. And with the tip, we're underway here in the first half. Fed the low block with the jumper.
Well, Dick, that didn't take very long.
I tell you, they're quick out of the gate, baby.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, the four around one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can't play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
In the lane, missed the jumper. Pushes it up.
Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. Nails a sweet jumper. Here comes the ball screen. And up and in and out. Momentary look from three-point land for the bucket. Drains it. Working it around the perimeter. From the corner. Knocked it down. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Drains the shot. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two. Buried it. He's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Gave it up. Tries for two. Off the mark. The shooting guard with the ball. Puts up the jumper. And come up short. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. He tries the jumper. Nope. He hits it. This guy's really known as more of a power guy.
I tell you, you know I like the way this kid uses his body, Brad. He's the type of guy you want in your roster. When you want that inside presence, his size and power is an asset.
For the bucket, he gets it to go. On the outside. Goes up for two. Off the mark. For two, the shot won't fall. They push it up on the break. On the dribble, gives it up. They've got a player spotting up on the three. He tries the three ball, off the mark. There was no doubt about that one. Tries for two. Comes up empty. On the outside. For the bucket. That's good. A high screen. Looking for a good shot. Cunningham picks up the foul.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You can never have enough leadership on your roster. If you're a coach who's lucky enough to have a couple of upperclassmen, you're definitely at an advantage.
Second one is good. Traps in place, Dick. Goes up for two. He drains it. They work it around the perimeter. He attempts the jump shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Durham receives the pass. Goes up with a shot. Missed it. Gave it up. He attempts the trifecta. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
He'd like to get it inside to the low block.
Well, you know, basketball was like nutrition, Dick. His game would be broken down into the two major food groups, and that's passing and score.
Tell you, Brad, he can get an easy 8 assists a game or put up 15 to 20 points on any given night. A well-rounded player who has a good feel for the game. I tell you, great footwork, too, to create that opportunity. And then he's got the touch. What an offensive player. Look at that spacing.
The jam. Number 11 receives the ball, goes up, the missed shot. Number 21 takes the pass. He goes up with it. They get it to go. He cut back door and the pass was delivered perfectly.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
With the J. They got it. Here's a double team. A little two-man action. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Change of possession. I think that one deserves another look.
Hey, look at him hammer this one down. Send a message, young man. Send a message.
Trap could spell some trouble. On the dribble, gives it up. Loose ball save. And we'll head back down to the other end. The baseline inbounds.
City.
The fans start to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Time to pick up the defense here now. They work the perimeter. 10 on the shot clock. Nope. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Two teams who are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
For two. Great shot. Moving it around the perimeter.
Coach looks on. Focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I'll tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Loose ball, saves it. Great play. They're set to inbounds from the baseline. They look to get it to the inside. He shoots the jumper. Can't connect. On the wing. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Makes the shot. Teams are looking to get something going here. On the left side, he puts it up, nails the jumper. Tucker handles the feed. Jumper, and nice looking jumper in the lane. Two. He hits the shot. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Ball down low. Puts it on the floor. Turn around a fadeaway.
Up and inside.
Jumper. Jumper won't go. The shooting guard takes the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He misses the fadeaway. On the dribble, gives it up. He looks for three. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
About 7 minutes remaining in the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. For two. It's good. The small forward receives the ball. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
He pulls up with a jumper. Scores it. About 6 minutes remaining. On the right side. From way outside. Nails the J. Number 33 is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
He needs for something positive to happen, which will light his fire and get him going.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. You betcha. And a momentary look from three-point land. He puts up the J and come up short. Puts up the J. The Buccaneers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
Low block. He pulls the trigger. Can't get the shot to drop. For the bucket. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad.
Timeout on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. They might try and surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
Way out on top, controlling the ball, off the mark. Working it around the perimeter. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. About 4 minutes remaining.
Sort of dumped out inside. Nobody rotated down from up on top.
In and out. On the left side. Throws it up. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Gets the J to fall. From the corner, bust the J. 3 minutes left on the game clock. Gave it up. He tries the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking for a good shot. Puts it on the floor and up and under. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
And it's knocked loose. Goes up for two. Missed the jumper. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. Out on the wing. From the corner. Knocked it down.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing. Stepping it, man. Take a look right here. Little Baryshnikov in shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the outside. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Takes the jumper. They got it. Trying to feed inside for two. He drains the shot. On the outside. With the jumper and score it. For two. The shot's off.
I love that block shot, Brad. Really gives you a lot of momentum.
Off target. At the half, the Bucks lead by 9. East Tennessee State is showing tremendous accuracy from the floor in the first half, partner.
They're so well coached, man. Working the ball around for the high percentage shot. That's a lot of maturity, man. They really are a mature basketball team.
With a man-to-man full-court press now, Dick. Looking for a good shot. The Gamecocks have a three-point shooter spotting up. And now the fadeaway jumper. Nope. The point guard gets the ball. He attempts the jump shot. Jumper won't go. On the left side. Working around the perimeter.
He goes up with it. Knocks it down. On the dribble, gives it up. He attempts the three.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Way out on top, controlling the ball.
Look at that spacing. Defensive transition's been very good.
There's a slam. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. The Buccaneers in attack mode. Controlling the ball. Oh, yes. They work the perimeter. He shoots the jumper. Busts the jumper. He cut back door and the pass was delivered perfect.
There's nothing like a well-timed backdoor cut and pass. I'm sure they practice that all the time.
Goes up with it. Busts the J. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Inside. He pulls up with a jumper. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if he were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
Gave it up. He puts up the J. Missed it. A hand in the way. Goes in. Goes up for two. The Buccaneers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Tucker handles the feed. He tries the jumper. Off the mark. Number zero handles the feed. Can't connect. The point guard gets the ball. Moving it around the perimeter. For two. Off the glass and no good. On the left side. Cross court. Tries for two. Knocks it down. Good find on that back cut, Mr. Vitale.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read.
The power forward takes the pass. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way and you spin back the other way.
The power forward with the ball. They got it. On the dribble, gives it up. Takes his jumper. Gets the J to fall. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. With the J. Missed the J. Give them points. That's goaltending. The Buccaneers have been getting it done tonight in a lot of different ways.
You know, everyone's been getting involved. Passing, rebounding, taking the ball to the hoop. A great team effort will always keep a team in it.
work it around the arc. He takes a three off the mark. For the bucket. He doesn't get the hoop to gets the rejection. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner and come up short. In the paint, his shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
Here we go. He attempts a jump shot. Nails a sweet jumper.
Up and inside.
Goes up. Nails the J. Top of the key. He shoots from the corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Number 12 gets the ball. Looks at a three. Busts the J. Gave it up. A whistle and foul. Coach not happy on the sideline. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man.
He misses the second shot. Pushes it up. It's not smart to just throw it out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Out on the wing. On the dribble, gives it up. He goes up with it. Busts the jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots from the deep corner. Nope. Goes up for two. Makes it. Got a nice screen. Try to pack it inside. Jumper. Missed it. Working around the perimeter. He shoots the jumper and score it. Here's the three ball.
Excellent jump shot right there.
The shooting guard handles the feed. Jumper off the mark. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
They look like they're having a blast.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper off the mark. Perimeter. puts it on the floor and up and under.
I thought a good post play because the footwork was excellent. So many guys walk with their pivot foot. He does a great job showing ball fake and good footwork, keeping his pivot foot down.
He fouled him. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, with him in the lineup, they've got one of the toughest things to get in sports, experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
First shot is good. This team is having some serious problems at the free throw line.
And it's a collective effort by all of them tonight.
And a momentary look from three-point land. For two. That was nice. Working it around the perimeter. He shoots from the top of the circle. Can't connect. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
Here comes the ball screen. The top of the key. Nails the fade. Gave it up. And once again, our two featured players here in tonight's Star Watch. Inbounds play on the baseline. For the bucket, he nails the shot. The young man cut back door and the pass was right on time.
I'll tell you, that was a great backdoor play. Terrific execution right there. The defense stopped concentrating for a second and they got beat back door.
And the fans are going wild.
You're right. The student set clock shot usually creates momentum and opportunity.
Cunningham on the left side. Jumper won't go. The Buccaneers were going to have to alter their style of play and play primarily in the half court from here on out.
At this point, playing in the half court would be a wise move. They don't really need to score, but do need for time to come off the clock.
Turnaround jumper. The Gamecocks will have to turn to their up-tempo and quick hitter playbook, Dick, from here on out. Neither time nor score is on their side.
Hey, their backs are against the wall, Brad. I know they're not an up-tempo team, but they've got to start playing like one. Time and score is not on their side.
On the dribble, gives it up. He fires away. Missed the jumper. Pushes it up. He tries to knock down the three. The missed shot. Sinks the shot. Seven minutes left on the game clock. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Pushes it up. For two. He doesn't get the hoop. Tucker receives the pass. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two.
They're trying to build an entire neighborhood with all those bricks, Brad.
They need some buckets, and they need them in a hurry. Puts up the jumper. Busts the jumper. The student body appears to be pumped up, and they are ready to explode.
Isn't it great, Brad?
He gets the rejection. And the ball out of bounds, but we'll be staying right here. Here's the inbound play on the baseline.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Out of bounds and a change in possession. Feed.
Trying to go inside.
Takes the fadeaway jumper. Buries the sweet fade. Edwards handles the pass. They got it. Puts up the J. Missed it. There's a double team waiting there. Long comes up with it. We're at the 5 minute mark. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. For the bucket. Nice shot. On the outside. Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
The point guard receives the pass. There they come with a double team to stop it. Edwards receives the pass. 4 minutes left on the game clock. Gave it up. Turnaround jumper. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Feed from the corner. Nope. On the outside. Goes up for two. Gets it to go. We take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
Inside, there's a hunt. He rejects it. A little two-man action.
Pushing that basketball. Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
3 minutes left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot. For two. Got it. This one will come in from the baseline. Perimeter. He the jumper and come up short. The point guard receives the pass. Tries for two. Can't connect. On the left side. We're at the 2-minute mark with a bucket. He misses it.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Sinks it. He cut back door and received the pass.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read.
Lobs it.
Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter thy lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
On the dribble, gives it up. Blocks the shot. Pushes it up. From the corner. Scores it. They work the perimeter. 1 minute left on the game clock. Moving it around the perimeter. From the corner. Off the mark. Basket's good. It was on its way down. Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. The inbound play will come from the baseline. Looking for a screen on top and got it. He wants a three. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
They'll work it around the arc. He makes the block. Obvious foul. Well, Dick, this young man's now in his second year.
Well, Brad, he's still mature. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
Misses his first shot. Makes the second. Shot clock is dead. They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He puts up the three ball. The missed shot. Well, we've got a moment here, Dick. Let's take a look at our players of the game.
Hey, two great young players here. Both stepped up for their teams and made this game interesting.